Hello everyone, welcome to PRV Solution. Today in this video we will study about the signal generation and analysis. Basically we have to study sine wave generators, which are also known as oscillators. So let's start. Signal generators definition: they provide a variety of waveform for testing of electronic circuit at low power levels. Signal generators are used in the laboratory and they provides different types of waveform for the testing of the electronic circuit. The characteristics signal generators must possess are stable operating frequency, stable output amplitude, low harmonic contents, low spurious output, that is hum, noise, modulation, etc. Means generated signals should be free from any distortions. The oscillator and function generator. So the term oscillator is used for the instrument that provides a sinusoidal output only, while the function generator is a term that is provides several output waveforms including sine wave, square wave, triangular wave, pulse train, as well as amplitude modulation of the output signals. So this is the difference between oscillator and function generator. Oscillator only provides sinusoidal output, while function generator provides different types of waveforms. Now classification of signal generators. The signal generators can be classified into the following categories: audio generators, function generators, pulse generators, RF generators, random noise generator, frequency synthesizers, and other signal generators. This is the block diagram of basic standard signal generator. Basic standard signal generator consists of two basic blocks, an oscillator and attenuator. This is the oscillator part, this is the attenuator part. The accuracy of the frequency, stability and freedom from any distortion depends on the design of the oscillator. So accuracy of the frequency generated by or frequency or stability or the noise free design of the oscillator, accuracy depends upon the design of the oscillator. The amplitude depends upon the design of the attenuator. This is the attenuator which changes the amplitude of the signal that is generated by the oscillator. This is the basic standard signal generator. Now the standard signal generator. This is the block diagram of standard signal generator. Here we have some extra elements like wideband amplifier, modulation oscillator, external oscillator may also be used. So standard signal generator have modulation capacities also. So this oscillator with modulation capacities, standard signal generator is an oscillator with modulation capacities. Modulation is done in wideband amplifier. Here modulation is done. Any external oscillator or modulation oscillator is used for the modulation. You can use any external oscillator or modulation oscillator for modulation purpose. So standard signal generator is nothing, it is a simple generator, but it has modulation capacities. Standard signal generator advantage: its output is stable. Its output voltage can be controlled according to the requirement. Disadvantage: due to LC tank circuit, frequency stability is limited. Takes some time to stabilize when new frequency range is changed. So when we will change the new frequency range, then it will take some time to stabilize. Application: used as power source for measurement of gain, signal to noise ratio, bandwidth, etc. It is also used for testing of radio receiver and transmitters. So this is the advantage, disadvantage and applications of the standard signal generators. Basic standard signal generator is also known as sine wave generator or oscillator. as we discussed, the term oscillator is used for the instrument that provides only sinusoidal signals of known frequency and amplitude. So what is oscillator? It is an amplifier with positive feedback. So amplifier with positive feedback act as an oscillator, or an amplifier act as an oscillator if and only if it satisfied the Bark-Hossain criteria. So what is Bark-Hossain criteria? So this is the Bark-Hossain criteria. It has 2 points. First point is, an oscillator will operate at that frequency at which the total phase shift introduced as the signal proceeds from the input terminals through amplifier and feedback network and back to input is 0 360 degree or integral multiple of 360 degree, means the total phase shift through the loop must be 0 360 or integral multiple of 360. Second condition is, the magnitude of the product of open loop gain and the amplifier open loop gain of the amplifier and the magnitude of the feedback factor is unity, means this is the open loop gain and this is the feedback factor, so its product magnitude must be equal to unity. So if an amplifier possesses these two conditions, then that will act as oscillator circuit. We know the transfer function of a positive feedback amplifier is this. This is the transfer function with feedback A upon 1 minus A beta, where A is amplifier gain and beta is feedback factor. So if A beta becomes equal to 1, means this condition, magnitude equals to 1, then this factor becomes 1, then gain of gain with feedback becomes infinite, which is the condition for oscillations. Now the principles of oscillations. Sinusoidal electrical oscillations are of two type, damped oscillation and undamped oscillation. So oscillator may provide damped oscillation and undamped oscillations. What are damped oscillations? The electrical oscillations in which the amplitude decreases with time are known as damped oscillations. So here the amplitude decreases with time, so these type of oscillations are known as damped oscillations. It can be observed that the amplitude of the oscillations decreases with time, though the frequency remains same, but frequency here is same. Why is it so? Why it happens that its amplitude is going to decrease and its frequency is constant? Why this happens? It is due to the loss of energy in the system producing oscillations. So this is the loss of energy in the system. Undamped oscillations, here frequency as well as the amplitude will remain constant, or it does not change with time. So these type of oscillations are known as undamped oscillations. Here the amplitude of oscillations are constant with time, there is no change in frequency. These are the oscillations which are used in the various electronic equipment. So these type of oscillations are used for the in the electronic equipment. These undamped oscillations are produced by providing an energy compensation circuit, because we seen here that this amplitude is decreasing here because of loss of energy. So if we do not want that there is decreasing in the amplitude, then we must have some energy compensation circuit in the amplifier or circuit of the oscillations. These undamped oscillations are produced by providing an energy, so we must use here energy compensation circuit. Now the circuit that produces these oscillations is known as tank circuit. Undamped or damped oscillations are provided by the tank circuit, shown in the next slide. The frequency of oscillation depends upon the parameter used in the tank circuit, L and C. L means inductance, C means capacitance. The frequency of oscillation is given by the following formula. Frequency of oscillation is 1 by 2 pi under root LC. Now we will study tank circuit. This is the basic tank circuit that is used for providing the sinusoidal signal. We are using here a switch, a capacitor and an inductor. There are four different situations. Let's study its working. First, the definition of a tank circuit. A circuit that produces electrical oscillations of desired frequency is known as an oscillator circuit or tank circuit. Tank circuit generates oscillations of desired frequency. The circuit arrangement to charge the capacitor of an oscillatory circuit is shown in the last figure. This one. So, working, when switch is closed, the capacitor C is charged to the external battery potential in the direction shown. Firstly, we will charge our capacitor with some external battery. Then, as the switch is closed, the capacitor discharges through the inductor L, thereby producing a magnetic field around the coil. This is the second condition. This will discharge and this electrostatic energy will go to the inductor, or it is converted into magnetic energy. And we know that capacitor stores energy in electric field and inductor stores energy in magnetic field. So, this capacitor's electrostatic energy is transferred into inductor in the form of magnetic energy. Now, the magnetic field set up around the coil begins to collapse and produces a counter EMF. In the this case, this magnetic field start to collapse, and then this will starts again charging the this capacitance, or the electromagnetic energy is now transferred to the capacitor, and this electromagnetic energy is stored in the capacitor in the form of electrostatic energy. The result is that the capacitor is now charged with opposite polarity. This charging and discharging of capacitor results in alternating motion of electrons and produces oscillations. So, this will produce oscillations here. Oscillators. Why oscillator is necessary? So, many electronic application requires electrical energy at a specified high frequency ranging from few hertz to several megahertz. We have many electronic application which requires that energy must be supplied at a frequency that will range from few hertz to several megahertz. This is obtained with the help of an electronic circuit or device called oscillator. These are used in radio, TV, radar and other communication or digital electronic applications. So, oscillators or oscillations are generated by oscillators and used in the radio, TV, radar and other communication applications. Definition: an oscillator is just an electronic circuit which converts DC energy into AC energy of required frequency. This is the first definition. Or second definition is, an oscillator is an electronic circuit which produces an AC output without any input. So, oscillators do not have any input, but it provides AC output, or it converts DC energy into AC energy. Now, the classifications of these oscillators. According to the design principle, we may have positive feedback oscillator or negative feedback oscillations, such as active device with negative resistance. Example of this negative feedback oscillator is gun diode, which produces microwave frequencies. क्लासिफिकेशन अकॉर्डिंग टू फ्रीक्वेंसी बैंड ऑफ द सिग्नल, ऑडियो फ्रीक्वेंसी ऑसिलेटर, हेयर द फ्रीक्वेंसी रेंज इज एंड इज नॉट रिटन हेयर, रेंज इज 20 Hz to 20 kHz, रेडियो फ्रीक्वेंसी ऑसिलेटर, फ्रीक्वेंसी रेंज इज 20 kHz to 30 MHz, वीडियो फ्रीक्वेंसी ऑसिलेटर DC to 5 MHz, हाई फ्रीक्वेंसी ऑसिलेशंस और ऑसिलेटर्स 1.5 MHz to 30 MHz एंड वेरी हाई फ्रीक्वेंसी रेंज इज 30 MHz to 300 MHz। क्लासिफिकेशन अकॉर्डिंग टू टाइप्स ऑफ जनरेटेड सिग्नल, सो वी मे हैव साइनोसोइडल ऑसिलेटर एंड नॉन साइनोसोइडल ऑसिलेटर्स, दीज आर नोन एज हारमोनिक ऑसिलेटर्स विद एंड आर जनरली LC ट्यून्ड फीडबैक और RC ट्यून्ड फीडबैक टाइप ऑसिलेटर। सो साइनोसोइडल ऑसिलेटर प्रोवाइड्स साइनोसोइडल ऑसिलेशंस एंड दीज हैव LC ट्यून्ड फीडबैक और RC ट्यून्ड फीडबैक टाइप ऑसिलेटर्स, दे जनरेट्स ओनली साइनोसोइडल वेवफॉर्म विच इज ऑफ कॉन्स्टेंट टेम्परेचर एंड फ्रीक्वेंसी। नेक्स्ट इज नॉन साइनोसोइडल ऑसिलेटर्स, दीज आर नोन एज रिलैक्सेशन ऑसिलेटर्स एंड जनरेट कॉम्प्लेक्स नॉन साइनोसोइडल वेवफॉर्म्स दैट चेंजेस वेरी क्विकली फ्रॉम वन कंडीशन ऑफ स्टेबिलिटी टू अनदर, सच एज स्क्वेयर वेव, ट्राइंगुलर वेव और सार्टूथ वेव टाइप वेवफॉर्म। सो नॉन साइनोसोइडल ऑसिलेटर प्रोवाइड्स अदर टाइप्स ऑफ वेवफॉर्म आल्सो, दैट इज स्क्वेयर वेव, ट्राइंगुलर वेव, सार्टूथ वेव एटसेट्रा। दिस इज द क्लासिफिकेशन बेस्ड अपॉन द जनरेटेड सिग्नल। The essentials part of an oscillator is it must have oscillator circuit, transistor amplifier and a feedback circuit. Let's study these individually. So this is the requirement of oscillator, 3 parts, tank circuit, transistor amplifier and feedback circuit. The following block diagram shows the essential part of oscillator. Working oscillator circuit. What is the use of oscillatory circuit? An oscillatory circuit contains inductive coil L and capacitor C connected in parallel with each other, which will form tank circuit. And the frequency of oscillations depends upon the value of L and C. Frequency of oscillation is given by 1/2 pi √LC. Next we have transistor amplifier. What is the use of transistor amplifier? A source of energy is required to compensate the losses in the oscillatory circuit. As we know that if we use only tank circuit, then there will be some losses occurs and we have their undamped oscillations. So to compensate that energy losses, we use transistor amplifier. That source of energy is the combination of a battery and the transistor working as an amplifier. The oscillator produced by the oscillatory circuit are fed at the input of the amplifier. Oscillations produced by the tank circuit are fed as the input to the transistor amplifier. The amplifier amplifies these oscillations. This amplified output of the oscillations is due to the DC power supplied by the battery. So this amplification of oscillation occurs due to DC power which is supplied to the amplifier. The output of the transistor thus obtained can now be supplied back to the oscillatory circuit to compensate the losses. So this output is supplied back to the oscillations through the feedback path to compensate the losses. Feedback circuit. This circuit is used to feedback a fraction of amplifier output to the oscillatory circuit. So feedback circuit is used for feedback output to the input to the oscillations. The phase of this feedback should be such that it adds the oscillations. The phase of this feedback means phase of this feedback circuit must adds the oscillations, that is positive feedback must be there. Phase is adjusted so that we may have 0 or 360 or integral multiple of 360 degrees or 0 degree and compensate the losses. Applications of oscillators. phase shift and wind bridge oscillators are used to generate audio frequencies. We have phase shift and wind bridge oscillator, which are used to generate audio frequencies, while the tuned collector, Hartley and Culpitz oscillators are used to produce radio frequencies. Crystal oscillators are used where high frequency stability is required. If you want high stability, then we must have crystal oscillators in that circuits. So these are the applications of the oscillators. Now we will study RC oscillators. So RC oscillators, these oscillators employ resistor and capacitor. As the name suggests, R means resistor and C means capacitors. These are more suitable for generating low frequency signals. So these are used for generating low frequency signals. These are also known as audio frequency oscillator. These have good frequency stability. Frequency stability is good. We will study here two types of RC oscillators. First is RC phase shift oscillator and then wind bridge oscillator. So RC phase shift oscillator is shown in the figure. It consists of three RC networks and one transistor. Figure 2A shows the circuit of a phase shift oscillator. It consists of a conventional single transistor amplifier and RC phase shift network. This RC phase shift network. The phase shift network consists of three sections, R1C1, R2C2 and R3C3. This is R1C1, R2C2 or R3C3. So this is the phase shift network. At some particular frequency f note, the phase shift of each section is 60 degrees. So that total phase shift produced by the RC network is 3 times 60 degrees, 180 degrees. And the frequency of oscillation is given by f naught is equal to 1 by 2 pi RC under root 6, where R1, R2, R3 is equal to R and C1, C2, C3 is equal to C. So this one RC will provide 60 degrees phase shift and the three RC circuit section provides total 180 degrees phase shift. And additional phase shift is 180 degrees provided by this transistor, as it is used in the common emitter configuration. So circuit operation, when the circuit is switched on, it produces oscillations. The output E note of the amplifier is feedback to the RC feedback network. This output of the amplifier is feedback to the RC feedback network. This is E note. This output is feedback to the feedback feedback path, which is equal to E note. This network produces phase shift of 180 degrees and a voltage E1 appears at the output, which is applied to the transistor amplifier. So this when this amplifier provides output, it will feedback to the RC circuit. A fraction of this V note is, that is E note, is provided at input to the this RC network, and this RC network after 180 degree shift, this E note provides output E1, which is the input of this transistor T. Here the feedback factor is E1 by E note. Feedback path, feedback factor is output upon input. Output of feedback path is E1 and input is E naught. The feedback factor beta is equal to 1 by 29 has an important significance. This feedback will comes out to be 1 by 29. For self starting the oscillations, we must have A beta is greater than 1. It means the gain A of the amplifier must be greater than 29, because here beta is 1 by 29. 29 will goes here, then A must be greater than 29. Only then the oscillations can start, which is necessary condition for oscillations. So a phase shift of 180 degree is produced by the transistor amplifier. A further phase shift of 180 degree is produced by the RC network. So total phase shift is 360 degree, which is the first condition of the Baer-Cosine criteria. It does not require transformers or inductors. Advantages: this circuit does not require any transformer or inductor, and it can be used to produce very low frequencies. It provides good frequency stability. Pure sine wave output is also possible in this oscillator. Disadvantage: it is difficult for the circuit to start oscillations as the feedback is generally small. So it will not start oscillation because feedback is small. The circuit gives small output. It requires high voltage battery, means transistor voltage must be greater than 12 volt. Second is the Wien bridge circuit. It is also an RC oscillator. The block diagram for or the circuit diagram for Wien bridge oscillator is shown in the figure. It consists of operation amplifier and RC network, that is known as Wien bridge network. Figure 2B shows the circuit of a Wien bridge oscillator. It consists of an operational amplifier in non-inverting configuration. So operation amplifier here used in non-inverting configuration. Two arms R and C in series with R and C in parallel are called frequency sensitive arms. So these RC in series with RC in parallel, these arms are known as frequency sensitive arms because the components of these arms decides the frequency of the oscillations. The component decides the frequency of oscillations here. Total phase shift required for the oscillator is 0 360 degree. So as this operation amplifier is used in the non-inverting configuration, so this uses 0 degree phase shift, which is the condition for Baer-Cosine criteria, and frequency of oscillation is given by 1 by 2 pi RC and root 6. Circuit operation: R and C are the components of frequency sensitive arms. Gain of the non-inverting operation amplifier 1 plus RF by R1. This is the formula for non-inverting amplifier op-amp gain. Output of amplifier is applied between the terminal 1 and 3, which is input to the feedback network. So output of this amplifier is applied between terminal 1 and 3. This output is applied between 1 and 3, which is input at the this frequency sensitive arms. Amplifier input is supplied from the diagonal terminal 2 and 4, which is output from the feedback network. So output of the feedback network means at 2 and 4 is applied at the applied as the input of this operation amplifier. So simplified feedback network of Wien bridge oscillator is shown in the figure. This is the series arm, this is the parallel arm. Let the impedance of this series arm is Z1 and this parallel arm is Z2, and this is the feedback voltage, output voltage VF, and this is the input voltage to the feedback network. So Z1 R in parallel with C, we will get this formula. Z2 RC in parallel, R and C in parallel. So Z2 R in parallel with 1 by J omega C, we will get this. Feedback factor is given by this feedback factor voltage across this, means Z2 by Z1 plus Z2 voltage divider biasing. Beta is equal to, so Z2 by putting the values of this Z1 and Z2, we will get this beta. So by dividing the numerator and denominator with a factor G omega RC, we will get this term. So here we have real part as well as imaginary part. So when this omega will becomes equal to 1 by RC, this 1 by RC, then beta becomes real. So if omega is equal to 1 by RC, we get value beta is real, hence it gives the frequency of oscillation at this value. So omega naught is equal to 1 by RC, omega is equal to 1 by RC, omega is equal to 2 pi frequency. So we will calculate the frequency from here. F naught will comes out to be 1 by 2 pi RC. Beta is equal to 1 by 3. To satisfy Barkhausen criteria, A beta greater than equal to 1, it is necessary that the gain of the non-inverting amplifier must be minimum 3. Means this A must be greater than equal to 3. As beta is equal to 1 by 3 here, so beta will 3 goes to here. So gain of this non-inverting amplifier must be at least 3. Means 1 plus RF by R1 greater than equal to 3, RF by R1 greater than equal to 2. So we will choose feedback resistance RF is the twice of the R1. So if these conditions are satisfied, these are the Barkhausen criteria. If Barkhausen criteria are satisfied in this circuit, then the frequency of oscillation is generated, and this frequency of oscillation is given by 1 by 2 pi RC. Advantage of this wind bridge: output is constant, its working is quite simple and easy, overall gain is high as it is using operation amplifier, it has far better stability, frequency of oscillations can be easily adjusted. Thanks for watching.